For it is by faith we have believed that God can do all that we ask and the things that we have imagined. Everything that happens to us is a communication of sorts. So you shouldn't think things happen to us just for fun or because you made some mistake or you were just smart enough. You have to see the future ahead of you and see that there are some people in your life that God does not want you to allow them to go into the future with you. God is always communicating with His children. Every time God is always speaking to you. You may want to know how this is done. You have always heard that God speaks to His people. But for once you have not heard God speak to you or you don't know what the voice of the Lord is like. Our God is an active and moving God. Without any course will He be limited by the circumstances of the world. Rather, He uses the things that happen to bring forth His divine purpose. When God speaks to you, He wants you to take the instruction with every seriousness because He is about to do some beautiful things for you. It will always be of your own greatest interest that God is saying to you, let go of that friendship and pull out of that relationship. You have stayed too long in this position. You have to move out of the place to a place where I want to establish you. Like the case of Abraham, when he heard the voice of God to leave his people and the land of his fathers and to a place where God wants to take him and to a place he knows not. Many times you hear that voice of the Lord speaking to you. Most times you refuse the instructions of the Lord. And because of the things God wants to do for you, He may likewise speak to you in signs and situations. So you must learn to understand the way of the Lord in your life. Some difficult cases may come as a sacrifice for you to be blessed. These things are the part of you may play before the doors of blessing as well as favor you have been praying to open to you. It may be difficult, but you got to obey the voice of the Lord. When God wants you to remove somebody from your life, you will begin to see some signs. And when you understand these signs, you will know what the heartbeat of the Lord is for you. These are the five signs that show up when God wants you to remove somebody from your life. Number one, they become the reason you are not moving forward. Most times friendship is a feeling of humor as well as pleasure. But whenever it's becoming some kind of reason, you are becoming loose plus not going forward as you ought to go. You should know that your relationship as well as your friendship with those people has expired and you need to move on without them in your life. The new level God wants to lift you into, they may not be the kind of people God wants you to move with into that level. You have to remove them from your life. When the people in your life becomes the reason your life as well as your destiny is not progressive and you have been made to stay in a place without any sign of moving forward, that is a sign that God is communicating something important to you. And that is to remove that person from your life and move on with your life. Number two, break in communication. You must understand that communication is the wheel of every relationship. There will be no progress in an organization or structure where there is no proper communication system. Whenever the communication system in your friendship with people is not as it ought to be, they communicate negative information to you. It has turned into some sign of vulgar as well as inappropriate word system. There are things you always want to hear from the people around you. And when it happens that they are not communicating the same information to you, then it is a sign that you need to remove them from your life so that God can bring those that will bless you with great information from the depths of great understanding. There are times that things last, though you must have enjoyed in the past some feeling with them, but maybe you have outgrown their level of communication, then you move forward. You got to remove them from your life. You cannot continue to have too many people in your life. Every person you have in your life should be able to stand in for some great importance in our life number, whether they become a bad influence on you. You must not see bad as a bad word. But when the result of your action is not pleasant and did not make out things in good form, then you could conclude that the actions are bad. The people in your life are supposed to be those that will guard you through the understanding of moral life. You are supposed to build a strong life as a Christian to prevent the influence of the world or the works of the devil, and to begin to find expression in your life. When all they do with you is just bad, all the ideas they suggest are the bad ones, and they don't have anything good to offer. This is a sign that God is telling you to remove these people from your life because they are not good for your coming days and they will corrupt your mind. They will not let the word of the Lord grow in you ritually and strongly. You must know that God wants to use your life to bless others. You are a tool in the hand of the Lord and the family you belong to, your circle of friends and your Christian assembly. Knowing this fact, you must then avoid some people that the devil will use to turn the blessings in you into something without value to the life of people. You look at yourself, you check those things in your life that are not suitable for the works of God in your life. Those things that will not allow the will of God to come forth in your life. Those things that have been struggling with the reality of the Word of God in your life. When you identify them, what you have to do now is you try to get those that are always making you get those things, those that are exposing you to such things that are growing into wrong elements in your life. When you are done with this, then you have to remove them from your life because they are going to stop you from achieving the plans of the Lord for your life, and in turn, making you not fulfill your destiny as a child of God. You have to see the signs and work with them. Because like the men of the Word that understands the Word of God in voice and sign, and they follow the instructions of God every time and season, you have to always check the results of the relationship with the people around you. If not, it is not producing good fruit, then it is a sign that God is telling you to remove them from your life. Number 4, when you are not learning anything from them. We relate with people to come to our best form. The people you have in your life determine the strength of your knowledge. When you have people of low understanding and knowledge around you, then you become like them. But for the life ahead of you, you have to know that you are supposed to learn every time of your life. When good happens to you, you have to learn, and when the bad happens to you, then you have to learn to, because everything that happens to you in life gives you a lesson to live on and develop yourself. Whenever you're not learning anything from people's life, then you are losing knowledge. Because when you stop learning, you start dying in your knowledge. Your life is for you to develop every time and others to equip yourself strongly for the future. And when the reverse becomes the case, then it is a sign that God is telling you to remove them from your life. They are not profitable to you. They are not adding any value to you. They are not contributing to your development. Having them in your life will always block the real people from coming into your life. The time has come for God to bring profitable people to your life. And He is telling you with these signs that you have to let go of these people from your life and allow the people that will help you go far in life with this substance they are going to fill you with to come in. Number 5, when their company becomes ungodly. Psalms 1 says, "Blessed is the man that does not walk in the counsel of the wicked, or stand in the way of the sinners, or sit in the seat of the mockers." As a devoted Christian and loving child of God and friends, you make the relationship you keep. The words of your mouth and your hangouts must always be a godly one. When the people you have in your life are becoming ungodly, and the things they do are not following the words of the Lord for your life, then it is a sign that God is telling you to part ways with them. The word of the Lord says that bad communication corrupts good manners. You cannot continue to have them pollute your God-loving life. The people in your life, the people you spend your life with always, the company you keep will always show how your life will always be. God is using a different sign to tell you the best things to do now, and that is to remove every seed of the devil from your life. Yes, they are seeds, because with them, the devil always plants things that are not in the plans of God for your life. God wants to take you far in life. He wants you to concentrate on your life in Him. Those people God is telling you to remove from your life are people that will always distract you from doing the right thing, distract you from achieving the will and purpose of God for your life. You have to make hay while the sun shines. You got to decide and take a step before it becomes too late for anything to be done. May God open your eyes of understanding and help you to remove bad people from your life in Jesus' name. Amen.